Odell here, the Creative Goddess, and I've got another great jewelry making project just for you. This one's a little more difficult than the last one, but I think you're really gonna like it, so be sure to stick around. I've been seeing lots of these great strands of beads in the bead stores lately. I think every company that makes beads has their own particular style of them. These are from Jesse James Beads, but I know lots of bead companies have them. They're really great. They have lots of color and texture and sparkle and all sorts of different beads on one strand. So the first thing we're going to do is cut this apart. Oops, we don't want to go too far there. And we're going to take a length of beadalon, gold colored. This is the 19 strand wire. So I'm going to take this length of beading wire and add a crimp tube and 1/2 of a clasp here. Now this is a solid ring. These are sold in my Etsy shop. There's no line in there, and there's not going to be any way that this is going to come off of the jump ring. So you can see I have the crimp bead attached to the half of the closure, and I'm just going to crimp and turn it. And so then that crimp is good, and I'm just going to string these on exactly the way they are on the strand that I bought. And another crimp bead. And this is also a fancy little jump ring that you can find in my Etsy shop. Again, there's no line there like there is in a regular jump ring, so that our wire won't come off of it. Over the ring and then back through the crimp bead. And then through a couple of these other beads here, just to kind of hide the tail. And then, I always say before you put on this last crimp to double check everything and make sure it's the way you want it to be, because there's sort of no going back unless you want to take the whole thing apart. Okay. Okay, the next thing we're going to do is to create a bead soup. You may already have a bead soup. You may have some beads that go with some smaller beads that you already have on hand. Or if you want, like I did when I was at Joann's, I picked up beads from, these are all from Blue Moon. And then this is a tube of beads that they sell. I think it's a Joann's brand. So I picked these up to go with these. I also got some chain because I liked that copper look in there. So we're going to get to work here and create our bead soup. More beads I found from Derice. I'm going to add those in. We have lots of seed beads and E-sized beads. Let's add some that are just a little bit bigger. Okay, that's it for the beads that I bought. Now, I've gone into my stash and gotten beads from my stash. Let's add those in. So because these are on individual strands, I can add a strand or two at a time and sort of test them out in my bead soup to see if I want to add them. And I do. So there, I'm pretty happy with the way that bead soup looks with the main strands of beads I've got going on and the chain that I'm going to add later. So let's get to the next step. Okay, so I have just a piece of foam core from a trifold board and my two main strands of beads. Okay, the trick to figuring out how long to make your necklace is to put this portion around your neck and then figure out how much longer you want your necklace to be so that it drapes around your neck in just the place you want it to be. So for mine, I need this part of the necklace to be 12 inches long. So I'm going to take a piece of tape. Two or three, whatever it takes. And I'm going to tape this right where I want it. So for the next part, you're going to need a good 3 yards or so to start with, a fire line, and an easy eye beading needle. You can also get these in my Etsy shop. I like them a lot because all you do is split that apart and put your thread in, your fire line, and you are ready to go. Okay, so we have our bead soup, we have our necklace, we have our line strung with, or our needle strung with fire line, and we're gonna go in here and I cut that a little long. Want to bet 10 bucks I end up getting it tangled? We're going to tie a double knot or a square knot. We're going to come back later and we'll put fingernail polish on that so we make sure that it stays where we put it. And then we're going to go in through here. So our string is now coming out from that bead. We're going to go into our jump ring there a little bit and around one more time. I just want to make sure that we anchor this really well. And then you won't be able to see that once we start getting all these beads on here. Okay, so let me just start picking up beads. We're going to make sure we want to put the smallest ones toward the ends. All the little seed beads and the E-size beads. Otherwise, the beads will end up being really thick. So now you see that we are here to this jump ring, and this is why it's important not to have a jump ring there that doesn't have a split in it of any kind. So we're going to take the fire line through that, and then we're going to go back into these last couple of beads here. Maybe like, what do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of these tiny beads. And then we're going to start adding more small beads. It's really important to have small beads on these very ends. Otherwise, you're going to end up with a lot of bulk there. And then we're just going to keep going back and forth and back and forth until we either get the look we like or we run out of beads, whichever comes first. Nothing's written in stone here. It's all, you know, just on this bead. So if you don't like the way it looks, you know, you can lay it down side by side and say you accidentally put two of these right beside each other, you can just go back and take it off. There's, you know, really no way to make a big mistake here. Just lay your beads down, look at them, and audition them in the place where they are. And if you like it, just keep going. As you can see, we're almost to the end of the thread here. And what I've done is I've tied a knot and I've gone back through the beads a couple of times and tied a couple of other knots. And then before I cut this thread off, I will go through and seal it with just a little bit of clear fingernail polish. Okay, so here's what I have so far. I have the two side pieces with the bigger beads on them, and then I have 10 strands of the seed beads and other beads that go in between those two side pieces. I was going to add a couple of different kinds of chain to this, but then I got to thinking maybe I didn't want to do that. And that's the really great thing about making your own jewelry. You can add or take away or just change things up however you want. If you did want to add the chain to this, you would just use a jump ring and add it and blend it in with the beads. All in all, this took a little over 4 hours to make. And it's not something that you could make just before you walk out the door, but it's definitely something that will get a lot of attention when you wear it. I hope you like this project and that you'll subscribe to my YouTube channel down below, because I have lots of other great projects ready and just waiting to video for you. Have a great day, and be sure to visit me on VickiOdell.com.